VidCon 2024 is here. Now, I went last year for VidCon 2023. Sadly, I didn't turn it into a vlog because I forgot, but this time it is here. Anyway, let's get into the vlog. So if you don't know, in the Atlanta airport, to get to each of your terminals, you have to take an underground subway tram thing. Now, however, when I went, the tram wasn't working, or it was just too much of a delay, so I decided just to walk all the way down. They had a bunch of art by a Zimbabwean artist. They were really cool. Also, they had a giant line of like the history of Atlanta, up from like after the Civil War all up to modern day. So that's really cool. And they had some other amazing decorated hallways too that was really cool to see. Now, when I met up with Bill here in Rand, I sadly didn't record, but I did get these highlights on the way to the Airbnb from the airport.
Oh my god!
Car future when you didn't see the clue. Help you get your lingo on. 21, get your first street cred.
Now, after we got to the Airbnb, we chilled for a bit, then we went to Walmart. And for some reason, this Walmart was inside of a mall, which was insane.
But these are for you.
Like, actually?
No.
There's one that was my
Wait, but actually.
Yeah, that's what
I'm... Wait, these are like an extra. What are you trying to say?
They're the only one that's there.
Hey, it's me, Goku!
Okay, Mama!
And also, inside the mall was like this mini Dave & Buster's type thing. We had no clue what it was. But after that, we got back to Airbnb. Order Wingstop and watch some YouTube. Then, to end off the day, I watched the final episode of Acolyte, which this episode of Acolyte was the one where it is now the first day of the convention. However, the first day of the convention is basically just pick up your badge. And that's what we did. But before then, we went down to IHOP to get a nice good breakfast before we head out for the day. Here we go. I realized I wasn't recording. Yeah, see, I'm just getting a bunch of B-roll stuff for voiceovers I can do. To VidCon, here we go. Let's go, baby.
Yo, I want to get a professional camera.
All right, there's the VidCon right there.
There's a VidCon.
It feels weird being back here again after a year. Yeah, that way. We are here. VC Social. It feels good to be home. Yeah.
Guys, lines are still running.
Oh, thank you.
Turn that.
Right this way.
Yep.
Right
this way.
It's actually not even going to pick up.
Yeah. Time to see anyone
I know. I see someone
with the Eevee hat.
We eventually made our way to the front of the line and I finally got my VidCon 2024 badge. With us now having our badge, it's time for the real fun to begin. Head out to the little plaza area and see how many creators we can meet. Throughout the video, I'll have a little counter in the top right corner of how many creators I was able to meet on this trip.
Oh yeah, so here's the actual place where we're... This is the expo hall right here.
Oh, okay.
Where?
God damn it.
Yeah, so right there is where all the stuff is happening in that building there. Oh, wait, there's a creator here. Hold on. Right there. That's what people lined up for.
Funky Frogman?
What is life?
It is life. Oh my god.
Do you want to get in line?
Where is this Funky Frogman? Please, you're too much. I love Funky Frogman.
I'm trying to shred these ones.
Now, after my friends met Funky Frogbait, we found the one and only Matthew Patrick. Now, however, he had to get going, so I barely missed the chance to meet him, but hopefully I'll be able to make it up somehow, maybe. But after that little MatPat mishap, we decided to make our way down to Downtown Disney to spend the rest of our day there. Now, when we got to Downtown Disney, we ran into some trouble. Apparently, when they were checking our bags, my tripod extended out, which I had no knowledge of. Now, since legally I didn't know about it, I should have been able to bring it in, but they forced me to get rid of it because it counted as a selfie stick. And Disney policy says no selfie sticks, but that policy is there for rides, and Downtown Disney didn't have rides. So yeah, I was pretty pissed about it. But I was able to, you know, buy a new one later that day, but I was still mad at the Downtown Disney security. But anyway, I still had fun at Downtown Disney.
Dude, I've always wanted to fucking see that. Is it hot? Oh, it's like the monorail.
Oh,
shit.
Yeah. Oh, hey!
This one's 3D printed. This one's an actual, like, from meteorite.
Wow.
What? That's actually badass, bro. What?
Looks like the Under Armour logo.
Only 25 bucks.
The 0.5. These are like 30 bucks.
Wait, who wants to guess how much this is?
Already bored.
How much is this, do you think?
$9. $9.99.
$15.
Oh, hell no. Oh, hell, that's exciting.
How much is the phone case?
Oh, hell, that's exciting. That's exciting.
Okay, Hero. Yeah. At Walmart, how much does this cost usually? Otterbox phone case.
Otterbox phone case? Like 30, 40 bucks? And like, oh, that's a one piece, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a plastic one. It's a plastic one, right?
Okay, so if I bring a bunch of fucking hair dryers
bucks.
To Disney,
about him being frozen?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, that's real.
Yeah.
That's gonna
dead ass.
Yes, they are.
Yeah. Like dead ass.
Oh no.
Like the employee tunnels underground, they pass by the room he's
yeah,
in.
Like yeah, like it's under the castle.
Yeah.
That's why they have so many secret tunnels.
It's real.
Yeah.
It is, dude. Look
yeah,
it up.
Bro. Yeah.
I'm not looking up right now. Hold on.
Look up Disney Frozen Route
34. You guys are fucking laughing at me. You guys are laughing. I was about to like pull up my phone. I actually believed you guys for a second. I actually did as believe
you
guys.
Hey, you don't anymore?
What happened?
It's true though.
I actually believe.
Wait,
you
guys. Actually?
Yeah, we laughed and it's true.
Yeah.
And we're really excited about it. We're really excited for his return.
We laughed because he said Disney Bros. In real time tour.
Yeah. Well, we're laughing because Walt Disney just told me a really funny joke. So.
Yeah.
I heard it from under the ground. Disney.
Frozen. They say you can hear his voice. Like,
Disney. Yeah. It's Walt Disney Frozen.
It was just a cover up.
Is it true? Let's see here. He passed away.
That's what they want you to think.
Yeah, he's not dead, bro.
Yeah.
They cryo-froze him in like the 60s.
Yeah. And
cremated.
No, he wasn't.
He was not cremated.
It's a cover-up.
Yeah.
It's a cover-up.
Yeah.
So that, like, we don't know that cryo-freezing is like a thing.
Yeah.
That's like something only like rich people can afford.
Fight their fiction.
And he was rich. He was like the
rich. Yeah, he was rich. He was Disney.
Disney helped in World War II.
What do you think Epstein went?
You know he didn't die in that trip. Yeah, because I'm a liar.
No, it's not.
ABC said it.
ABC's a joke. Because you know Disney owns ABC, right?
Exactly. They do.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah.
Disney owns ABC.
That's not even a lie.
Yeah.
They do own ABC.
Look, who owns ABC?
They own it. They're trying to cover it up.
After exploring Downtown Disney, me, Hero, and Blaze decided to go to Cheesecake Factory with a bunch of other creators who were going to VidCon. Now, the food there was amazing. I had this like amazing chicken sandwich thing. It was so good. But after that, we went back to the Airbnb. Today is technically the first true day of VidCon 2024. Now, today was a very big day. I had 3 of my 4 meet and greets today. And I did the Technoblade cosplay today too. And you'll see what that looks like when I show off the, you know, little meet and greet session. So we started off today heading to the VidCon Center around like 9, 10 a.m. to get early for a meet and greet since me and Bill both at AMC. Once we got to the Con Center, we made our way to the one and only meet and greet hall where we meet all of these creators. Since we got there around 9 o'clock, we had to wait in basically an hour for the meet and greet to start at 10. Now, when we got to AMC, I did record Bill's meet and greet with him, but sadly Bill forgot to record my segment with Amesy, but here is the pictures I took from the Amesy meet and greet. Now after that, we explored the, you know, the expo hall and such, and we found there was a Minecraft booth for the 15th year anniversary, so we decided to check it out there, and we took a bunch of pictures and videos. After that, I think I got lunch, I'm not sure, this is around maybe 11 or 12 o'clock or so. But the next big thing was that we met Purpled and Wally Bear. I wasn't able to meet them. Well, I did meet them, but I didn't get a picture with them. But those are two more creators I met. But after that, I went ahead and lined up for my Airt meet and greet at 2 o'clock because I really wanted to get an early line.
Oh, yeah. Hey. Yes. Oh, yeah. See it?
There we go.
Yep. Awesome. Hey. Hi.
That's so cool.
Thank you.
That's
thank
so
you.
Cool.
Yeah. It was a lot of work.
I can imagine.
Thank you. How do you want to do the picture?
It's up to you.
You choose.
I don't know. My go-to is the pizza.
We can do that. Yeah, we can do that. You want to say anything for the vlog right there?
Oh, hi vlog.
Oh, get the mic right here.
Hi vlog. Hi mom, I'm on TV.
Thank you.
So after I got done with the NEHU meet and greet, we walked by the Minecraft booth because we were heading to the main expo hall area. And then the Minecraft social team flagged me down saying, hey, we want to interview you. So here is that interview.
Hi, I'm Anthony, and we're here at VidCon 2024. I'm here with... Can just a little bit of a spiel.
Yeah.
The outfit is amazing. Yeah. What was the inspiration for?
So I did it back in 2022, right around like... I decided to do a cosplay because I had this axe that made from a previous cosplay of another creator. So I decided to do techno because I did it right before his, you know, sadly death that year. So I decided to get all this stuff together and make an insane cosplay that took like lots of money and lots of effort from me and my, you know, my late dad and all.
It's absolutely amazing. I love the entire Thank you. Outfit so much. But also, I'd love to also ask.
Yeah.
Off the top, you guys had any time to prepare? What is your favorite Minecraft moment of all time? Like, looking back mm-hmm. to the past, you know, whether it be content creation, in the game, whatever it might be.
Yeah.
What's your favorite?
So I was on this hardcore SMP back in 2023 or so. I accidentally placed a bed down in the Nether, an accident, and that's how I died.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Well, speaking of hardcore mode, any interest in trying out the new hardcore mode?
I will eventually. I still haven't played the new update yet because I've been working and all, so I haven't had the time to play it.
Gotcha.
But it looks really fun. I love the new armadillo and the wolf armor and stuff as well.
Yeah, love it. Well, for anyone who doesn't know who you are, where can they find you?
ZekRom916 over on YouTube, Twitch, TikTok, and Twitter.
After that, I basically headed over to the meet and greet because it was about time to meet them. It was around 5 o'clock when the meet and greet started, so I wanted to get there on time. After sitting there in the line for like maybe what, an hour or so, I finally got to meet Arret. I met him at TwitchCon 2022, so it was like 2 years ago since I last saw them, and it was really nice to meet him again.
Hey.
Oh my god, I saw your outfit from the start. It's
Did
so
you?
Cool.
Yeah.
Microphone on?
Yeah, it's the DJI one.
Nice.
I got a person vlogging for me too.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. How do you do? You want to do the heart thing?
Sure.
I don't know how to do it. Was it?
Just go like that.
Is it this hand or this hand?
You got to put your thumb out.
It's like that.
Like that.
Yeah.
Like.
Oh, okay.
You want to come a bit closer?
Oh yeah, sure, yeah. Oh, you want to sign this real quick?
Absolutely.
You can make it as big as you want because this book is for signatures.
Perfect. I like signing big.
You can take the whole page if you wanted to.
Not that big.
Oops. There you go. Thank you. You have a good evening.
You too.
Thank you.
Sometime during the day, one of the techno dad editors came up to me and wanted a picture of me with the cosplay. They sent it to Techno with Dad, and here was the response he gave. But because of the cosplay, I got so many amazing free gifts that people came up to me, and probably like 10 or 15 people wanted pictures with me because of the cosplay. But after that, I decided to call it a day because it was like 6:30, and I was exhausted and hungry. So I just took an Uber back to the Airbnb. And that was the end of day 3. Now, day 4 was probably one of my favorite days. The reason for that is that I finally got to meet my favorite creators, Jetlag the Game. Now, if you don't know who they are, here's a little snippet from one of the trailers explaining what it is.
On Wednesdays, you'll get a new episode where me, my writers, and our pseudo-celebrity guests play games where the world is our board. The first series follows me and Brian from Real Engineering playing Connect Four across the United States, racing my writers to see who can connect four states first. The second series goes even bigger.
But yeah, I went to their Nebula panel up in the Creator Lounge. After that, I walked downstairs, and I met RecRap, so that was cool. After that, I decided to explore the expo hall a bit with Ran, Bill, and Hero. However, my audio glitched and like something happened, so y'all just get, you know, silent videos with music in the background. But we did go to the little drawing area. While looking around the expo hall, we went to this booth where you can get a free boba tea. Since I never had tea or boba before, so we went to go to try it. Now, it was all right. I had a milk tea. The boba was awful. I hated the little ball things. But the tea in general was all right. But also, we saw CG5 was doing a meet and greet in this little booth. That's pretty cool. But after that, I quickly went to my purple meet and greet. I felt bad because I did rush it because I was trying to get to a jet lag, the official jet lag panel that happened like at 5, I believe it was. And I think it was like 4:55 when I was meeting Purple. So I was trying to rush through it. I sat down at the jet lag panel. After it, I met some really good creators that are part of jet lag, like Toby from Tibby's and Michelle Cray. I don't know what happened. I did run into one of my friends, Fan Fandy. But after that, we took one final photo at the one of the VidCon signs. And to end the day off, Fizzy Ice invited me and a bunch of other creators to go to Sky Zone.
Now try to get out.
First try?
Good job.
Evenly distributed.
What's that? That's crazy. Extra cheese pizza.
Double cheese pizza.
Do it.
I was thinking about throwing it.
Full bite.
Full bite.
No, full bite.
Oh my god.
Is it good?
Mm-hmm.
No way.
Charge it up.
No, charge your hands up.
Your knuckles are so red.
Bloody ass knuckles. No,
I swear to God.
Today is the final day of VidCon. Now, with it being the final day, we found out that a lot of creators did meet and greets today. The start of the day, we found out that Ted Nivison was doing a pop-up meet and greet, so we rushed out of the Airbnb and met Ted Nivison. While we were in line with Ted, we saw Hank and John Green during a panel, so technically I saw them, but I'm not going to count it. After that, we found out that there's a long line at Minecraft booth, and we found out that Afmal was doing meet and greet there. Now, I used to watch Afmal all the time growing up, like back with the Pixelmon Hour and Cold Days, and when My Street first started out. But with My Street coming back, I may return to her content. We still see, we'll see. But after that, we decided to get lunch. Now, while I was getting lunch, I saw a familiar back of the head. I saw Santi from Food Theory, so I finished my food quickly, ran over there, and I got to meet Amy from South Theory, Tom from Game Theory, Santi from Food Theory, and Ash, the GT Life camera person. Now, Lee was at the hotel, so I didn't get to meet him, and Matt, Pat, and Steph were off somewhere doing something else. But after that, we ran into Average Heary and Cup Toast. And the funny thing is, we were making jokes all weekend about meeting Average Heary, so that was pretty cool. Then after that, I met up some other people. I met up with someone from the Sky Zone event and Cheesecake Factory, and I got to meet Rose Thunder, so that's pretty fun. Now after that, I got to meet a pretty cool creator. He's an Australian creator called Matthew McKenna. He does reaction content of songs, of shows, and stuff on his channel. He's actually a really good person. We were talking for like 30 minutes, and I would have talked more, but like my feet and legs are hurting, so I wanted to get going. But after that, this is around like 5 o'clock or so, maybe earlier. I can't remember what time it was, but yeah, nothing much happened today. But I did find Hero and Blaze sitting by the fountain before we decided to call the day and head back to Airbnb. I did take some final photos of the con center because I wouldn't be back here for another year for VidCon 2025. But back at the Airbnb, Hero decided to warm over his Cheesecake Factory leftovers, and the container kind of got destroyed. But for me, I decided to order food from this new local restaurant. It was all right, but this is what the food looked like. The final day where everyone is in Anaheim, California. Now, since Hero's flight was at 12 a.m. for some reason, he had to leave around 9. Bill and Rand were leaving back together, and they left the Airbnb, I think, around 7 a.m. on Sunday. For me, however, my flight was until 10 a.m., so I left around 8 a.m. or so. Now, VidCon this year was a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun for last year, too, but this year I just got to hang out with more people, meet all my favorite creators I want to meet. However, there are some things I didn't get to do, like hang out with Days or Vulpus more, Endemore, or go to an escape game. But however, there are plans for next year, though. Me and Bill here will probably Airbnb again for next year. And I've already looked at some options for a big, nice Airbnb. But yeah, that was the VidCon 2024 experience. Now it is time to go fly back home for basically 12 hours.
Closing time. Open all the doors and let you out into the world. Closing time. Turn all of the lights on over every boy and every girl. Closing time. One last call for alcohol, so finish your whiskey or beer. Closing time. You don't have to go home, but you can't stay home.